H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Okay, people, as you know, so this is a mock session, and every week I'm supposed to discuss a module. And this week, as per the plan, people, I'm supposed to talk about project management module. So what happens here is I'll be bringing up some very important project management questions. Okay, I'll teach you the technique of answering that. I'll make you work on the answers. Okay, that is how it would go. And before that, people, the first 5 minutes will be repeated in each and every mock session, people. The first 5 minutes will be repeated in each and every mock session. So this first 5 minutes, people, will tell you how exactly you should be structuring your answer. What should be the approach of your answer? Okay. First, let me go through that, people. Let me go through that. So people, always remember, whatever you speak, the minute you open your mouth at the time of interview, whatever you say, it should match with your resume. Always, you got to have resume in your mind before you give any answer or before you talk about anything. Okay, so let's say, people, always first comes the resume, people. First, you know, the question does not come first. The resume comes first, remember. So let's say, people, if this is your resume, let's say you have put up three projects. Let's say you have put up a project saying Bank of America, New York. Okay, let's say you have also put a project saying Chase Bank, Ohio, Columbus, Ohio. Okay, also you have put up a bank like Wells Fargo. That is in San Francisco. Let's say these are the three different projects what you have in your resume. Okay. So let's say, people, the question asked is about MS Visio. Let's say they ask you, are you good with MS Visio, or are you familiar with MS Visio? Have you worked on MS Visio? Anything of that kind. So in this case, people, this is your resume and this is the question. How would you frame an answer? Okay. So remember, people, always first you have to start with a very positive yes statement. That is, you say, yes, I am good with Visio, or you can use a word like, I am experienced, okay, with Visio, okay, I am proficient, okay, proficient with Visio. People, there are some words which does not carry weight, still you can use, let's say if you're not that confident with the talk, with the question being asked. So the you can use words like, I have a knowledge. Okay, or else you can say, I am familiar. Okay, I have an idea. See, these words, they don't carry value. But anyways, people, let's say if you really don't know the topic at all, so you can use such words. Okay, so that is, people, yes, that is, you start this way. Yes, I'm good with Visio. Okay, and then next, people, next what you have to do is, you got to give number of years of experience what you have on this. So you can say, I have 3 years of experience. 3 years of work experience. You can say that. Or let's say, people, if you're not that confident with the thing being asked, you can just randomly say, I have 1 year of academic experience. I have 1 year of academic experience. Even academic experience will be considered sometimes. And step number three, people, you give a definition. See, definition is not required. It sounds very bookish. Just talk about it. Just talk about something relevant to Visio. We can say MS Visio is a Microsoft tool which is used to do different types of diagrams, okay, and things like that. Okay. Step number four, this is the most important one. That is, you got to relate. You got to relate. Relate in the sense, you got to somehow, join Visio with the projects. So that is, you can say, you know what, I've used Visio in my recent most project in making use case diagram, UCD. I've used MS Visio to make activity diagram when I work with Chase Bank, Ohio. I've used MS Visio, okay, to make, sequence diagram when I work with Wells Fargo, my first project. See, this is how the answer should go, people. These are the different words that you can use. These are the different sentences you can use. But this should be the overall format. People, I'll give you 3 minutes here. I want you to make note of it and understand this. And after this, people, I'll start asking you one question at a time. And I'll ask you to frame an answer based on the structure shown on the screen. Again, I'll be giving you the solution. This is how the whole class will go. So let's say, people, if you don't have any experience or if you don't want to show any experience, see, what you can do is just you can stop yourself until definition. you can just ignore the fourth step, that is relating thing, you can stop. Okay, maybe you can end your answer here. Let's say if you don't have any experience or if you don't want to put any experience in your resume. Okay, Dipali, is that thing clear? Fine. So people, I'm about to clear the screen. I hope everybody has made note of it. Okay, fine. So let me ask you a question, people. So this is the question. Are you familiar with project management? Or let's say the question can be modified saying, have you done any project management in your previous job being a PM? Or have you contributed? Have you involved yourself in project management? See, there are different ways to ask this question, but it means the same. Okay, people, and you got to assume these projects, that is Bank of America, New York, Chase Bank, Wells Fargo. And people, you have 8 minutes. I want you to frame an answer for this. Okay, based on the structure what I showed you, I want you to frame an answer for this. People, you have 8 minutes. Your time starts now. People, does anybody have any question on the question being asked? Does anybody have any question on the question being asked? Well, the time is up. Why is that? I don't see any answer from you, Pooja. Not Pooja Jain, the other Pooja. Okay, Shruti Gagunta, I don't see number of years of experience being mentioned. I don't see number of years being mentioned. Okay, Amrita, looks fine. Okay, again, Pooja Jain, I don't see any number of years being explained. Number of years of experience being mentioned. Okay, fine. Aishwarya, looks fine. See, here the answer says, yes, I'm pretty familiar with project management from my previous project. I have 3 years of work. See, when you say 3 years of work experience, I don't think so the word familiar would justify. So 3 years means it's quite significant. You can say I have a good amount of experience. Familiar means it's a very weak word. Familiar, knowledge, idea. It's a weak word. Anita. Dipali looks fine. Now people just watch here. People always, you try to give a different story for a different project. Okay, so this should be the answer, people. This is my way of answering. So here it says, I'm proficient in project management. I have 4 years of work experience on the same, and I have, and 1 year of academic experience as I've done project management in my graduation, something like that. I'm about to give PMP certification. I'm trying to kind of, you know, give a story here. In my recent most project with Bank of America, I've contributed towards project management by doing estimation using 3-point estimation technique. Means I'm trying to sell this 3-point estimation technique story for this first project. And in my first project with Wells Fargo, I did not get chance to work on the project management. Yes, that's true, people. See, people, this is how the real time looks like. You don't get chance to work on project management for each and every project. Okay. So here I'm trying to give that scenario here. I remember in my project in Columbus, Ohio, I was acting as a helping hand. See, this is the thing, you know, that matches. You really don't do a project management, actually speaking. You give a help. You get involved. You don't do it, but you get involved in some or the other way. Okay, people, this is how the answer should look like. Okay, let me... why is that you have confusion, Nadia? So, you see, as part of this business analysis course, we did teach you project management, isn't it? So this is that part of it, Nadia. Yes, everybody are BA student. In this class, everybody is a BA student. But in this course, you learned about project management, which is part of BA. So that particular topic I'm covering this week. Okay, so the next question is, people, have you done estimation of projects? Again, people, remember, you got to sell a different story for a different project. Always have that thing in your mind. Okay, so looks a little bit better, people. But again, this is my way of answering this, people. Kindly watch here. People, but I see some people, you know, they're not able to give a different story for a different project. You got to work on that. Okay, so it says, yes, I have 3 years of work experience on time estimation. Time estimation is an approach to identify the duration of a project. In my recent project with Bank of America, I've used 3-point estimation to figure out the duration of the project. I remember in my first project with Wells Fargo, I used a technique of 1-point estimation. See, again, a different story. And my project in Columbus, Ohio, I was not responsible in doing time estimation as we had exclusive project manager to do this. Again, it's a different format of the story. Okay, people, I'll give you 2 minutes. Kindly make note of it. Yes, for every question, you have to mention years of experience, Aishwarya, because please don't look at this from your point of view. See, look at from a recruiter's point of view. See, always a recruiter wants to know how many years of experience you have on that. Okay, based on that, he decides whether to proceed with you or not to proceed with you. Okay? Okay, the next question is, people, tell me about yourself. You have 4 minutes for this. Okay, people, again, tell me about yourself. Okay, people, again, it should be based on, the resume. Okay, it should be based on the resume. Okay, Sanju, do me a favor, call me tomorrow between 12:30 to 1:30. Okay, I'll try to counsel you and see, what can be done.